Good morning, my dear students. Now we discuss about the anti-epileptic drugs. So first we discuss about the what is the epilepsy. So epilepsy is a group of disorders of the CNS. It is a group of disorders. Group of disorders of CNS. So it is a number of disorders occurs in the central nervous system is known as a epilepsy. So it characterized by the which type of disorders? It characterized by the paroxysmal. Characterized by the paroxysmal cerebral disorders. Paroxysmal cerebral disorders. So these are the occur in our central nervous system. It leads to the disorders. And the next one, loss of disturbance of the consciousness. Loss of disturbance occurs in the consciousness. And the next one, without characteristics of body movements like convulsions. So loss of disturbance means it is nothing like seizures. So in occur in our body, number of disorders occurs in the central nervous system is known as the epilepsy. So in epilepsy, it occurs as seizures and convulsions occurs. And the next one, it is the sensory and psychotropic phenomena. It is also known as a sensory or psychiatric phenomena. Psychiatric phenomena. So epilepsy is a focal origin of the brain. It is a focal origin in the brain. What is the origin? It is a in brain. Origin in the brain. And the next, manifestation depends upon the site of the focus and region, discharge of the spread and postural depression. These are all are occur in our body is known as the epilepsy. So the epilepsy is a treatment by using of the anti-epileptic drugs. So the anti-epileptic drugs is a by using of the anti-epileptic drugs. It is a cure or prevented by the anti-epileptic drugs of the particular epilepsy of these type of characters occurs in our central nervous system. What are the drugs? It is classified into several types. And what are their classification? Now we discuss. So what are their classification? So first of all, these drugs is example is the barbiturates. Barbiturate example is the phenobarbital. Phenobarbital is example. And the next one, hydination. So hydination example is the phenytoin. And the next one, third one classification, succinamide. Succinamide example is the ethosuximide. And the next one classification is the newer drugs. So what about the newer drugs? Newer drugs example is jonisamide. Newer drugs example is the jonisamide. And the next one, deoxybarbiturates. Next classification, deoxybarbiturates. Example is the primidone. And a lot of classifications are there. So this is some classification with examples. Now we discuss about the phenobarbital. Now we discuss about the phenobarbital. So the barbiturates is the, what is the chemistry of the barbiturates? So chemistry. So it is chemically, this chemically it containing the 6-membered ring. And one ketone group, this is the ketone group. This one is also ketone group. So total 3 ketone groups are there. This is called as R2, R1 methyl groups. So this is called as a phenobarbital. So most of these are used as a anticonvulsants also. Why? Because of convulsion is occur also in the epilepsy. It is used as a anticonvulsions. Used as a anticonvulsions. And the next one, these are the particularly it containing the 3 ketone groups, 2 amine groups are presented. 2 amine groups, 3 ketone groups, 2 amine groups are presented in their structure. So this is about the barbiturates. So the phenobarbiturate, what about the phenobarbiturate? So the phenobarbiturate is a structurally containing the sodium molecule also. Here sodium molecule also is known as the phenobarbiturate. So what about the phenobarbiturate, this one drug? Phenobarbiturate, it is a odorless white crystalline powder. Odorless white crystalline powder. It is a odorless white crystalline powder, but bitter in taste. It is a bitter taste. And the next one, this what is the molecular formula of the phenobarbiturate? This is the barbiturate chemistry. What is the molecular formula? Molecular formula of the phenobarbiturate sodium. Phenobarbiturate sodium molecular formula C12H11NaN2O3. So NaN2O3. This is the molecular formula of the phenobarbiturate. And the next one, the phenobarbiturates. This phenobarbiturate sodium, what is the phenobarbiturate sodium structure as per molecule? So phenobarbiturate sodium molecule structurally, same structure, draw the same structure. NH C double bonded O. Here C double bonded O. But in here it is a look like a one more benzene molecule. It is look like a benzene molecule. So this is about this benzene molecule, but in this condition attached to the C2H5. So this is about the, this is the O-NA molecule. So this is called as a sodium phenobarbiturate structure. Phenobarbiturate structure. So this is a barbiturate chemistry. This is the phenobarbiturate structure. So that is the main difference between barbiturates and phenobarbiturates. So it is a chemically, these are the different, both are different. Why? Because of the containing the 2 rings, but it actually this phenobarbiturates containing this chemistry is enough. In this phenobarbiturate chemistry, this is the phenobarbiturate chemistry. And the next one, what is the mechanism of action? What is the mechanism of action? So mechanism of action, what is the mechanism of action? Phenobarbiturates is the decrease the impulse transmission. These are the impulse transmission decreases, and as well as the increase the cerebral cortex level in the CNS. Cortex in central nervous system. So the impulse transmission is decreases. The central nervous system, all disorders are decreased by this mechanism of action. And the next one, what is the dose? So the dose is for the adult dose. What about adult dose is the 100 mg to 350 mg divided into 3 doses, divided into 3 doses. This is the IM route only, administered through IM route only. What about the children's? What about the children's? It is the children's dose is the 6 mg per kg body weight. 6 mg per kg body weight, 6 mg per kg body weight. It divided into 3 doses per day, 3 doses. So, it one is also administered through intramuscular route, intramuscular route. And the next one, this adult dose for only which one route? Oral route. It administered through orally also. How much of drug? Just 30 to 120 mg only. 30 to 120 mg only per a day, 3 times. And what was the children dose orally? It is the children dose is a daily per a day 6 mg per a day. 6 mg per kg mass. 6 mg per kg body weight divided into 3 doses. This is the oral dose. So, in here, in this condition, this is about the dose of this particular drug. And in here, the next one, what is the any side effects and contraindications for the dose? So, first of all, contraindications. What are their contraindications? The contraindications, it is mainly affected to the hypersensitivity patients. Hypersensitivity patients, and it leads to the next one in here, hepatic diseases and diabetes, means increase the blood glucose level, pregnancy, lactation, hyperthyroidism. So, these are the these mainly affected to this patient. That is the contraindications. And the next one, write the side effects or adverse effects. So, side effects is the common side effects. Nausea, vomiting, headache. Skin rashes also occurs in our body. And local pain. Pains also occur in the body. Sometimes our body, some parts are swelling. Drowsiness. So, these are all occur in our body after administration of the phenobarbital sodium drug. And the next one, what about the pharmacokinetics? So, pharmacokinetics is that these drugs are administered through orally and IM route. So, the IM route is 60 to 70% more absorbed from the IM route, and just orally it absorbs the just 30 to 40%. And the next one, distribution. It distributed through the body fluids and blood. And the next one, metabolism. It mostly metabolized by the liver and excreted through the urine. It excreted breast milk also. And the excretion, it excreted through as a breast milk also. And the next one, what is the half life? T-off. Exactly 100 hours. This phenobarbiturates is especially, half-life is 100 hours. So, in children, this is about the adults. In about children, what about 75 hours in the children's? 75 hours in the children's. And the next one, in here, what is the pharmacodynamic parameters? So, pharmacodynamic parameters, it is increase the effect of CNS depressants. Increase the CNS depressants. And the next one, it is decrease the effect of the phenobarbital, decrease the heart rate. These are pharmacodynamic parameters. And the next one and last one is the role of nurse. So what is the role of nurse? So assess the respiratory depression
to assess the respiratory depression
and to assess the fever, to assess the rashes,
jaundice,
and the next one, check the mental status,
to check
mental status also, and the next one, study about the liver function test, and the next one, take dose exactly advice,
to take dose exactly advice to the patient,
advice to the patients, and the next one, evaluate the drug response, and etc. So this is about the anti-epileptic drugs. So if you have any doubts from this topic, tomorrow we will discuss. Thank you.